Rajendran sir.
Can you see that?
Yes sir. Yes sir, you minimize that and you open your presentation sir.
Now can you see? Hello? Hello?
Sir, a white screen is getting presented.
Can you see now?
No, sir.
No?
No, not yet, sir.
Ramesh. 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 Just a minute, I'll check it up.
Okay, no. Sir, now you minimize the screen, I mean the one, then you can open with your presentation.
Now can you see now?
No, sir.
It's not opening. Now I can see now. Can you see now?
No, sir.
No, sir, not it.
Not it, huh?
No. Yes, I can. Yes, I can see your presentation.
What is that?
Read it. Behavioral. Yeah, behavioral characteristics of
users. Oh, behavioral characteristics of. Okay. Just a minute. Huh? But it is not coming here.
You minimize it. You minimize it, sir. Minimize the screen. You open your. Yeah, it's. Now your presentation is visible.
It is there, huh? but yes. Overall people are there. I couldn't see here.
There are 126 here.
126, huh? Okay, and start.
Yes, sir. Start, sir. Start.
Okay.
Sir, go for slideshow, sir.
Okay.
Yes, perfect, sir.
Good morning, all the participants of 5 days program on leadership and excellence, start from 31st of August to 4th of September. I think I take this opportunity to thank the Mr. Arisha, the coordinator, who has taken a lot of pain. Actually, he is a good leader. Before the program starts, he was consulting more than 10 to 15 times what are the topics to be included and everything. And also I take the opportunity to thank Mr. Devaraj, principal, nicely organized this online course on leadership and excellence. I think nearly 128 participants are participating right now. I think it is a very big, the occasion to the Harisha take a lot of pain in conducting this program. That is why the large number of participants are here. Even last week I conducted a program, I got only 65 participants from various polytechnic. Now the topic is given, a very wide topic. What are the behavioral characteristics of leaders? The first question is, so far what we understand about the leadership and leadership qualities, how this particular topic is different from the earlier speaker. What are all I'm going to talk about, it is related with the psychological aspect of the leaders. To start from, now I ask the question to the participants, either the leaders are born or made. Any one of you? Participants? I request the participants, give your feedback.
They are actually posting their answer on the chat box.
Pardon?
They are posting their answer in the chat box.
Oh, let me see that. Okay. Hello.
Sir, minimize this screen, sir. Minimize this. Yeah, now your presentation is visible.
Okay.
Go for slideshow, sir, please.
I asked the question. Any one of the participants can answer it? Okay. The leaders are born or made?
Both is right, sir. Leaders are born and made, I believe, sir.
Okay. What do you mean by born?
Born in the sense means from their birth itself, they will be having that kind of leadership in their means in their physical as well as their mental beliefs, sir.
Good. That made means?
Made means in some certain circumstances, I think, because of the pressure from others or in our mind itself from seeing somebody, we will be getting that means that sort of thing to become a leader, sir.
Very good, very good. Excellent, madam.
Thank you, sir.
The leaders are born means there are certain DNA molecule, all right, from our leaders. We call it as Motilal Nehru, Jawaharlal Nehru, Indira Gandhi, like that, from the family hereditary. That means the leaders are born. The leaders are made. It is nothing but through the training program, there are certain qualities a person lacks. He can be trained, right? Now, the next question is, I go to the... You say teachers are leaders. Any one of the participants, please react to my question. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir. Teachers are leader.
Teachers are leaders. How?
Because we have to lead a whole class and we have to create enthusiasm to students to prepare for exam and all. If we talk 1 hour very effectively, they may change their orientation to the studies and all. For that purpose, the teachers are leaders.
Okay.
Sir, teachers are the torch bearers of classrooms, sir, for a generation. Okay. So they are really leaders.
Okay. Suppose in online program, you are not available directly. Then how do you call it as teachers are the leaders? Because there is no face-to-face interaction with the students and teacher relationship. In the earlier days, it's okay. Offline program, on online program, do you accept that? Do you accept that teachers are leaders?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Of course,
sir.
or online program also, teachers are leaders. Okay. Because they are the people who plan, execute, and manage the things to be discussed with the students.
Okay, good. So basically, the teachers are called academic leaders. Teachers are called academic leaders. Then the principal, they call it as academic administrator. There is a difference between the academic leader and administrator. The administrator having some kind of the managerial skills like a planning, organizing, staffing, controlling, evaluating. So thank you for your answers. Right. There are three basic characteristics which is needed for our leader. I'm not talking about the political leader. I'm talking about more of academic leader in this particular topic today. The first one is knowledge. Second one is skill. Third one is attitude. These three components are the basic characteristics of leader. If any one of the component are missing, he may not be effective leader. That's why we call it as a leader and effective leader. So the first one is knowledge. Knowledge is nothing but knowing things from a book, from seeing a particular person, you are getting some kind of learning. It is called experiential learning. We are surrounded with a lot of knowledge. Knowledge is nothing but information. Madam, knowledge otherwise called, any one of the participants? Knowledge otherwise called. Hello? Hello? Any one of the participants? Please react my question. Hello?
Understanding, sir.
Understanding the concept or content. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then. Suppose you are teaching
it. Comprehension, sir. What either it is a grasp, comprehension, grasp, command, mastery.
Mastery over the subject. Am I right?
Yeah, over the subject or expertizing skills of the subject.
Oh, yeah, good.
Or our proficiency. All these we call it as a knowledge, sir.
Okay. So a leader must have good knowledge about the subject, right? Whatever the subject, you must thorough knowledge on that. Then followed by skill. The difference between knowledge and skill, the knowledge is nothing but knowing, but skill is doing. All right. So skill otherwise also called experiential learning through knowledge. But it is highly debatable, all right? Whether knowledge is dependent on the skill or the skill depend on the knowledge, still is a very big question mark. Then once a leader possess knowledge and skill, that is equal to attitude. Attitude, nothing but a behavior. It is a kind of feelings, all right? In this program, 5 days training program, you are getting a lot of knowledge. The first day, developing leadership skills, then followed by achieving professional excellence, power tools of leadership, and leadership strategies, cultural and organizational change. Like that, for the past 2 days, you got certain knowledge on the subject. But how we are going to utilize in your day-to-day life or in your classroom, that is what you call a skill. Apply the knowledge in a real setting. It is known as skill. If a leader possesses both knowledge and skill, he may have a attitude. The attitude can be a positive attitude or negative attitude or maybe neutral attitude. Attitude can be changed over the period of time. The earlier days, this kind of faculty development program, the psychologist labeled the training program nothing but attitude change program or behavior modification program. You are having a neutral attitude towards leadership and excellence. But after getting a lot of information, knowledge, and skill, doing certain exercise in the afternoon, you change your attitude from neutral to the positive. Right? Many of the training programs, or nowadays they call it as attitudinal change program. If you are not change your attitude, then there is a failure on the part of our training program. So K plus S equal to A. It can be measured with various psychological tools, how far your attitude has been changed. So the later I'll talk about more of psychological tools which are available to measure about the leadership attitude. Knowledge, skill, and attitude, though it is independent, but in process, maybe an interaction with others, it is interdependent. Knowledge is dependent to skill. Skill is dependent to knowledge. You understand, participants, the difference between knowledge, skill, and attitude? One other participant, you can react.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What are the skills are needed for a particular academic leader? All right. The psychologists have classified, there are five types of skills is needed for human being. What is called technical skill, right? Technology oriented, know-how. Suppose you got your BE qualification, ME qualification, PhD, etc. Subject wise, you are mastery over. But human skill, how to approach another human being. It is otherwise, it is called interpersonal skill or social skill. If you want to give training program on the second aspect of the skill, we call it as interpersonal skill, assertiveness skill training program, social skill training program. When a person, a faculty member, possess both the technical knowledge and also skill, and also interact with the other person, maybe a student or his own faculty or colleague, etc., it is known as conceptual skill. The combination of both technical skill and human skill, it is known as conceptual skill. The next one is perceptual skill. The last one is psychomotor skill. Now you are operating your computer or laptop, it is nothing but psychomotor. Psycho means mind, motor means bodily actions. It is called a skill. So what I want to give the importance on that, the leader should have the maximum of the second component, what you call it is human skill or social skill. Let us move to the next one. There are seven behavioral qualities or the characteristics which is highly needed for our academic leaders. I'm talking about every time academic leader. I'm not talking about much on religious leader or social leaders or maybe political leaders. The first one is called intelligence. Intelligent psychologists always call it as IQ. Please kindly note down, IQ means intelligent quotient. Quotient means there is no decimal value. Participant, you understand what do you mean by IQ? Hello?
Intelligence, quotient, sir.
Q U O T I T E N T. Quotient means there is no decimal value. That is only for comparison purpose. All right. We call it as IQ, intelligent quotient, MQ, memory quotient, EQ, emotional quotient, SQ, social quotient, then SQ again, spiritual quotient. The quotient, there is no decimal value compared with one individual to another individual. I'm going to talk about more on the later, then followed by the different type of memory level. So the leader should have very good memory capacity, then followed by level of thinking, creativity, personality, attention, and concentration. I'm talking about more on psychological aspect, right? The first one is intelligence, high level of intelligence needed for the academic leader. Then memory, good memory level, then level of thinking, creativity, personality, attention, and concentration. Now you are going to get the information, each one, everyone in detail. Right, what is intelligence? Suppose you are a very good teacher, or excellent teacher today. It is not your contribution. It is a contribution from your parent and forefathers, because you got the intelligence, IQ, from them. Suppose your grandchildren, granddaughter became a good scientist, that means your contribution. So the lot of research studies found that, right? Genetical predisposition or DNA molecules, that is why it is called intelligence, nothing but innate ability to acquire the knowledge and apply for different situation, right? So you are adjusting. Today online program is there, so you are also adjusting. You are making your students also adjust to the classroom, all right? Though it is different from the offline program, but this kind of uniqueness of adjustment, what do you call it, is intelligence. Respected participant, you understand what is the intelligence? Hello.
Yes,
yeah,
sir.
You understand what you mean by intelligence? You heard about the word intelligence? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Intelligent test and all. I'll tell about what is intelligent test. It is inherited nature. What is inherited nature? DNA molecule. Right?
Yes. Yes, sir.
So it is proved in the theory that hereditary, the parental DNA, right, carried over to the children. IQ 80% we are getting from our parents or forefathers, but only an environment 20% it is contributing. That is why we always thinking about, we wanted to put our children in a very good SBS school, DAV school, Narayana school, etc. Why our teachers not preferring of government schools? Anyone can react? Hello? Participants? Please react. Why we are not sending children to the corporation or the government school?
Hello. Yes. Am I audible?
Due to improper environment.
That is why environment. So environment is necessary. So environment make the student to be disciplined. Why we are looking for good school in the sense? Good school is not only in a building. It is a characteristic building. Right, so our children's going to get a very good characteristics. That means they are going to be a disciplined citizen. Once they are disciplined, you will get the learning. If the students are indisciplined, that does not mean that corporation school, they are not providing the, what you call it, as very good discipline. No, it's not at all. But in majority of the cases, all right, in a private school or non-governmental school, they are very strict about watching over our students' behavior. That is why we call it as, we must give the conducive environment to our children. It promote the intelligence. So intelligent quotient, as I told you, how we are going to calculate. As I told you, the leader should have very good high level of intelligence. So the role of hereditary and environment. So this is the test. Please go through the test. This is one of the tests. So there are the picture is there. Can you see the picture here? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
One place there is a vacant, is there?
Yes, sir.
So there are 8 alternatives are given. 8 alternatives. So you have to choose one, the best suited to that. Alright? Like that, we have the intelligent test in our laboratory. For children, one type of test. then that is called colored progressive matrices, standard progressive matrices, and advanced progressive matrices. Advanced means it is only for 18 years onwards. So the time is given within 20 to 25 seconds. You have to answer it. This problem is very simple. But there are 48 items are there. The speed is more important. Like that, intelligence can be measured through this kind of test. I'm showing some of the test model, not entire test. This kind of test you can see in the competitive examination. Those who are writing competitive examination, they call it as mental ability test or test of reasoning or general intelligence test. How far you are very sharp in order to address the answer to the question. So if you take too much of time, that means the intelligence is very less. If you take more time, then intelligence is very less. Sharp, you are taking very less time. Within 10 seconds, you are answering. Intelligence is very high. Through your performance with the time limit, we can judge our intelligence. See some of the models, pictures, I brought it here. Can you see the participant? Can you see these pictures?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Like that, some of the, there are 48 items are there. 48 items with the time limit. We have to give it to the either individual or maybe in a group. Even it can be given for individual, right? Suppose lack of attention, lack of concentration, disturbed in nature, mood swings, this kind of students are disturbing in your class, then you may be referred to the clinical psychologist or maybe psychiatrist. Then they will go for a mental examination. Please write down what is that called? Mental examination. Power of mind. So they will give this kind of test. They finally, they'll give the score also. From the score, we can find out. All right, how to calculate the IQ. This kind of picture will be given to 1 to 1.5 hour to a boy or girl. So finally, it is called MA by CA into 100. MA means mental age. This mental age is measured through the test which I shown right now, divided by chronological age, that means actual age. Right. Now, one of you can work out, a boy undertaking a test at the age of 17 years, the test score revealed that his mental age also, that mental age means maturity. That is also 17 years into 100. What is the score? One of you tell me.
100%.
Pardon?
100%.
100%. So 17 by 17 into 100. 100. This 100. Is one boy score. That's called A. B is the boy, madam, 17 years old. Okay. But his mental maturity through the test, 16. Into 100, what is the score? The boy age is on 17 years. The test he was taken, 17 years boy having a mental growth of 16 years into 100. What is this IQ? Yes.
120, sir.
Pardon?
120, sir.
No, no.
94%.
94%, okay.
Yes.
Yes. See, another person, 17 years old boy, through the test we identified his mental age is on 18 years. Highly matured. All right. Now, what is his IQ?
94.
No, no.
105%. 105.
Good calculation. Right, like that. In your class, there are about 40 students are there. 40 students having different type of IQ. Once we get to know their IQ, then it will be picturized universally like this. Please kindly note it down. Kindly note it down. This is called universe all over the world. Right? Please make it a 0, 25, 50, 70, 80, 90, 110, 120, 130, 140, etc. Like, so in our polytechnic, the college, we are getting most of the time the student from here to here, not here. Right? These are all the disturbed cases, mentally disturbed cases. Write down the author name is Stanford Binet. S-T-A-N-F-O-R-D, Binet, B-I-N-E-T, T silent. Stanford Binet classified the human IQ into several types, call it as zero, idiot, imbeciles, moron, feeble-minded, borderline, below average, average, above average, superior, genius. Shall I once again repeat? If it is a zero, idiot, 25, imbecile, then morons, feeble-minded, borderline, below average, average, above average, superior, genius. For example, what is this particular IQ? It is related to the leader's qualities. If a leader comes over here, 110, 120, all right, the way of his thinking, his wavelength of thinking is different from others. Right? For example, the leader is having average intelligence, but the follower, subordinates, right, they are having much more than. Then there will be a difference of opinion. Because these people give 110, 20 type of IQ people give different kind of opinion, which these people may not accept it. Right? According to the statistics, there are 10,000 people born in this world. Kindly note down. There are 10,000 the people born in this world. One became a mentally retarded. One become a gifted genius. One become a mentally retarded out of 10,000. One become a gifted. Madam, tell me, what do you mean by gifted?
Means a genius, sir.
Genius. Suppose in your class, one student is genius in nature by birth. It's difficult to handle the boy. Why?
He'll be having more opinions and more doubts will be there from his part.
Yeah, he is the person more of creative in nature. You do not like the stereotype of your teaching. Every time the student, gifted children, needs some kind of a change. All right? So that is why a boy, one or two, girl, happened in your class, the class will be disturbed in nature. So we always tell about our teacher, polytechnic teacher, that whatever we are going to handle the classroom, right, teaching learning process, right, two times we have to repeat, not one time, right? Either introduction you have to give for 5 minutes, followed by 40 minutes you have to give the content or development stage, or you give more of content 40 minutes, you have to summarize 5 to 10 minutes in end. So if you are giving your lesson, right, for two times, right, the average, the student be able to understand. Understanding, retention, recall. This is the memory process. That is called URR principle. Write down, participant, write down URR principle. What is U? U stand for understanding the content delivered by the teacher. R stand for retention, keeping in the memory, number of days, number of years. The last R stand for recall. Two type of recall. One is called verbal. Another one is called return. So we call it as interview. Interview is called verbal recall. Written examination is the performance recall. It is known as performance recall. So if I am a teacher entering the classroom, if I take only one time the subject, both content, either with introduction or maybe summarization, only one time out of my 1 hour, I don't want to repeat. What will happen, participant? Only one time I repeat. Please react my question.
Only the intelligent can understand, sir.
Intelligent can understand. All right. That is for the minimum we have to repeat, right? Two times, starting with what is the importance of this particular topic. And end, right? What do you understand from that? Right? So 2 times if you repeat, the more than 80% of students will be able to understand. My point is able to understand. All right. For example, if I want to repeat 3 or 4 times, what happened? Those who are here below average, 88, 89, 90 IQ, rarely we happen to get this kind of student. They will only benefit. If you repeat 3 or 4 times, this boy and girl, 110 and all, they feel it is a boring. They always feel that the teacher exhausted their learning material. That is why she is repeating, right? So this kind of conclusion they used to get in. So my point of view that the leader should come over more than 110 IQ level so that their perception about the world, perception about the people, perception about the environment association different from the average person. Their decision making is different, right? Their involvement, approach with other human beings are different from others. Now, the next one is very important, the aspect of leader qualities, memory quotient, memory. The whole examination is based on the capacity of memory. All of you agree? Participant?
Yes, sir.
All right. It is memory based. Right? So today students having a semester mark of 80%. But the 80% is carrying over only in the mark sheet. Whether today the person having 80% of that particular knowledge about the subject, big question mark. Am I right? Psychologists are identifying there are 14 types of memories are working with human brain, right? So what are these 14 types? Kindly note it down. First one is called SM, sensory memory. That is called body language. IM, immediate memory. Nothing can be stored in the cerebral cortex area. STM stands for short-term memory. The information will be there for few minutes to few hours. The next, the fourth one, it is known as LTM, long-term memory. The leader must have this kind of, the fourth one quality, long-term memory. They never forget about each and every individual and their issues. Due to biochemical changes in the brain, something we used to get it forgetting, that is called delayed memory. The people call it as this kind of people will be a tube light and all. The pickup is very late. This kind of delayed memory of the student always go with some kind of bit and all, small piece of paper they used to write down all the information. By practice, VM stand for visual memory. AM stand for auditory memory. Your listening. The 8th one, ASM, associative memory. You are going to associate. Whenever you think about Delhi, Agra, immediately you think about Taj Mahal. SEM, 9th one is called SEM, semantic memory. It is called multiple choice. There are 5 alternatives are given. The which one is the best one to the question. The 10th one, it is called PM, procedural memory. The computer, you go with the procedure, right? Suppose you want to Google Meet, right? You have to go by step. One memory help another memory. It is known as working memory. WP, working memory. DEM, 12 one is a DEM, declarative memory. What is declarative memory? Whenever you happen to see the photo and caption, I saw that Dr. Rajendran is in NITTR. I attended one program, but which program I do not know. But certificate it always carry with me for CAS program. So declarative, you are going to declare that NITTR where Dr. Rajendran is working. Right? The 13th memory, it is known as natural memory, God given a gift, natural memory. It is very uniqueness. The last one is known as trainable memory or trained memory. Some of the memory can be trained. Psychologists are identified. There are 14 types of memories are working with us. But happen to be a leader, the leader should have the highest memory on the 4th one. It is called long-term memory. They are special human being. When compared with other, right, they should be cognitively sound. Cognitive means mind, active and alert, so that other followers, other subordinates, other students would admire the special qualities of a particular leader or a teacher. Now, any one of your participants can tell about all the 14, if possible, without seeing from the screen. Yes. I'll check your memory also. Participant. I think 128 participants are here. One of you can tell me about, without seeing your notebook. Just now I told you about there are 14 types of memories are available. What are these 14? Hello. Participant, react to my question.
Sir, it is sensory memory, immediate memory, short term, long term, delay, visual, auditory, procedural, trained, and natural memory. I can't recall at this time.
Good, good. Any one of the madam, one of the madam will tell about all the 14. Women participants. Hello.
It is trainable. Trainable memory.
Okay. No, I'm asking one of the madam.
Sir, sensory memory. Immediate memory. Visual memory. Delayed memory.
Not initial memory, immediate
immediate memory. Short term memory.
Okay.
Long term memory. Auditory memory.
Auditory memory.
Associative memory. Semantic. Semantic memory. Procedure memory. Declarative memory. Natural memory. Trainable memory.
Okay, working memory. I think your memory is good. Okay.
Yes, sir.
But one thing you can understand, all the participants, there are some tablets are available. But I have to. But psychologists having different kind of views, taking any kind of medicine, or the vegetables, right? That may not enhance your memory. It is only a the faith, but only doing things number of times, right? That is exercise only for good for improving memory rather than taking a tablet, or maybe a syrup, or maybe an greens or any vegetables. You know, these are all give some kind of psychological satisfaction, but physically nothing can happen there. Right. The next important the aspect types of thinking. The leaders, what are the qualities which is needed for a leader? The point of thinking. So there are six type of thinking, what is called logical thinking, analytical thinking, critical thinking, divergent thinking, and lateral thinking. So the leader should have train on all four types of thinking. What is logical thinking? Right? Logical means without any kind of analysis, right? We have to come to the conclusion. All right? For example, in mental ability test, all the cows are dogs. All the dogs are monkeys, therefore. So through the Venn diagram if you put, you will get an answer for that. Right? There is a logic which you have to arrive, right, as an answer. Right? For example, we call it 10 plus 5 is equal to 15. This is called mathematics, pure mathematics. But whereas in test of reasoning, you have to reason, tell about the reason. Where it will come like this, 10 plus 5 is equal to 45, 20 plus 5 is equal to 95, 30 plus 3 what? So you have to answer the first, you understand the first two, that is nothing but multiplication minus subtract second number, you can call it as what you call the answer. 20 into 500 minus 5, what do you call it as 95. So it is go with some kind of logic. Analytical thinking more of those who are expert in what do you call it as mathematics, statistics, physics, chemistry. So it needs more of analytical ability. All right? Critical thinking. Critically evaluate. When you do your project work or any PhD work, so we call it as critical analysis. So how far the earlier studies, review of literature, all right, are going to help to set a hypothesis or the objectives in your study. So you have to critically, right, find out how earlier research bridging a gap between earlier and maybe in future. It is called critical analysis. But it is highly used in politics, right? Present government wanted to say something about the opposite government, right? Telling about these are things you done it. Critical. But it needs a lot of historical, right? The data and all. Data is more important in critical thinking. The next one is called convergent thinking. the difference between convergent thinking and divergent thinking, kindly note down. Convergent thinking, nothing but it is a kind of intellectual ability. Divergent thinking, nothing but a kind of creative ability. For example, I am asking, madam, one of the madam can answer it. You are reading your favorite textbook for 1 to 10 pages continuously. How long time will take? With understanding also. Not skimming and scanning technique. One of
maybe half an hour, sir. Maybe half an hour.
No, you. What is your favorite subject?
I'm in the area of textiles, sir.
Pardon? Computer science?
Textiles.
Ah, textile. Right. Introduction to yes. Some part I can call introduction to textile. Right. Suppose you read a particular book, 1 to 10 pages.
Okay.
Right. Understanding, retention, and recall. Three aspects. Understand the content, keep it in your memory, use all the 14, then recall. It takes half an hour? Okay, good. Very good memory power. Madam, after half an hour is over, I'll give a sheet of paper. Can you reproduce what are all you studied for half an hour, 10 pages? Can you repeat it?
Maybe 80%.
Why? Ordinary Xerox can do it 100%. Madam, Xerox, 1 rupee Xerox can do it, madam.
Xerox can do, sir, but human cannot do it.
That's right. Whether who is a superior, Xerox or human being?
In human this aspect, only, Xerox.
You know, Xerox only invented by human being, not natural, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
That is why I'm called it. Everything comes under the one focal point. The students, right in your classroom, 90 hours they are spending in your classroom, right, physically, which is an offline program. But they are going to write one English examination only in 3 hours. They are reading 100 pages of the textbook, but finally they are writing only 10 pages. So all the ideas, put it in one focal point, that is what they call it as convergent thinking. At one focal point. Divergent thinking. Madam, you are reading a book on the introduction to the textile management, etc. One or two pages you are reading. After that, you close the book. Critically, you are analyzing it. You start write down maybe on 10 or 15 pages. Is it possible or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes? Critically, yes. You can analyze about it, right? It was given, this kind of ideas given 1960 and 17. Now 2020 you are living. These ideas, no more usage. So you are thinking differently. So you read about only 1 or 2 pages, but you start writing maybe on 5 or 10 pages. That is called divergent thinking. It is called creative ability. Yes. What's creativity? Create activity. It is called creativity. Kindly note down. Create activity. It is called creativity. We wanted to produce, we wanted to make our student to be an more of creative ability rather than intellectual ability. This is I want to focus. A leader must have very good divergent thinking. In addition to that, they should have the other criteria like a logical thinking, analytical, critical, everything. But much more than, a leader should be a creative ability person. The last type of thinking, what do you call it as? Lateral thinking. Solving problems indirectly with creativity. That's called the incubation period, we call it as. Right? So there are 6 type of thinkers are available. Next, creativity. As I told you, create activity. It is known as creativity. The program of leadership, not making number of followers. The objective of the training program on leadership qualities or the leadership skills to promote the leadership to others. leading the characteristic of leader to another person. So important characteristics needed for a academic leader: creative abilities. There are a number of psychological tests are available. Due to the lack of time, I am unable to provide. The next important aspect, it is called personality. One of you say about what do you mean by personality? Yes, participants, please react.
Sir, it is an internal and external characteristic
of human being. Am I right? Personality never tells about this physical appearances. Yeah, physical appearances in add-on, feather to cap. Write down person plus ability, it is called personality. Person plus ability, it is known as personality. Person plus capability, it is known as personality. Person plus potentiality, it is known as personality. A personality referred in terms of the characteristics of individual plus added value, you can call it as a dress and other costumes. Eysenck, a great psychologist who was identified earlier, there are 5 types of personality available. The last one is not fit into 1 to 4. It is called psychotic. It's not normal. It's called abnormality. He call it as introverted, extroverted, ambivert, neurotic, and psychotic. So his theory is based on the functioning of ANS, autonomic nervous system, and the PNS, peripheral nervous system. The activation of ANS, autonomic nervous system of sympathetic and parasympathetic, and PNS, peripheral nervous system, this activation, an individual showing certain characteristics to others. He may be an introvert, extrovert. What is the quality of introvert? Feeling of isolation, fear of failure, feeling of inadequate, low self-esteem, lack of self-confidence, right? Not moving with other, socially withdrawn. So all type of character together, it is known as type. That's why it's called a type. Each and every character is called a trait, T-R-A-I-T. Trait mean characteristics. All the characters together, it is called type. So psychology, you don't have to think about, it's a very big subject. No, every day we are using. Suppose in our polytechnic, we are commenting on another teacher. This teacher is such a type, mood type. Another teacher is very talkative in nature. So type is based on cluster of combination of various characteristics. You understand, participant? What is introverted? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Tell me about what is the extroverted quality. There are certain jobs which need extroverted quality. Yes, salesman.
Salesman, yes, sir.
Policeman, all right? Those who are security personnel, licensing officer, all right? Because they wanted to move with other people, introverted. Oh, sorry, maybe what do you call it as a person is a manager, receptionist, all right? So these people are mingled with another human being. They should not be introverted. Introverted means intrapersonal difficulties. They are having a lot of what you call ill feeling, right? There are certain job which is needed extrovert quality also, all right? Extroverted person may be socially moving with others, no fear of failure, easily get your friends, talkative nature, disturbing others, restlessness, right? This kind of qualities. For example, an introverted person married an extroverted person, then very difficult adjustment in the family. right? Both of them are introverted, no problem. The child becoming extroverted. Both of them are extroverted, always going to the mall, shopping and all. Seeing the characters of parent, the boy don't want to go outside. So a person having both introverted and extroverted is called ambivert. What is that ambivert? One of you tell about what is it? What do you mean by ambivert? Hello? Participants, please react. Because I'm
both extroverted and inverted, sir.
Ah, both. Very dangerous quality. Very dangerous quality. He'll act and react. He always with us, showing different characteristics. But only few people are available in the world. All right. So I'm not using a chat box. See, please just talk to me. Right. Please react to my question. And the leader should have the highly of extroverted characters. And next one is neurotic. Neurotic, always fear, always guilt feeling, always stressful. Unable to meet the people. If I go and talk, what the people will think about it. Always thinking about others. All right. That's called neurotic. They become a problematic person also. And a person do not fit all the four, he call it a psychotic. Right? Mental illness, right? Schizophrenia, manic depressive disorder, this kind of characters. This is the earlier days, our characteristics have been classified into introverted, extroverted, ambivert, neurotic. Today, new type of research, they found that instead of personality, they call it as a behavioral type. I wonder if you can read it about the behavioral type. Hello? Please, I'm not using a chat box.
Sir, behavior types are assertive behavior, passive behavior, aggressive behavior, passive aggressive behavior, and cluster behavior.
Good, madam. Assertive behavior is an asset to an organization. Suppose you found out there are a number of training programs which I have been available here also in NITT at Chennai. We are conducting a program, assertiveness skill training program or social skill training program. There are five types of behavior. The first one, the best in order to get employability. Assertive person is the asset to an organization. One who is realizing his own potentialities. Accept. All right. That quality, it is called assertiveness. Right. Without violating feelings of others. Other qualities like passive aggressive and all, the person switch over to assertiveness. Otherwise, it is very difficult to get into a problem, maybe in a job or employability. If a person very passive in nature, otherwise he may be earlier I told you about introverted. So if you found out your children also coming under passive aggressive and all, there is a time, there's a needed, right? So they get trained to be an assertive person. If you're assertive person, any part of the world, all right, you can sustain, you can get a very good job. All right, there are a number of training programs are available. Now the question is, the assertive behavior is highly needed for what do you call it? It's a leader, it's academic leader. What do you mean by cluster behavior? Combination of all four. Out of 1,000 people born in this world, one became a cluster, combination of all. Suppose a person assertive behavior, 75% to 80% you'll always assert, but go to the office or maybe in a house, you'll very passive, right? A principal very assertive in a college, 88% to 90% in his office work, but go to his the house asking your wife, why don't you give me a cup of coffee? Where he cannot show assertiveness, he can show the passive. You want to act in order to get one cup of coffee because survive, no? So you cannot expect 100% everywhere, assertive 100%, no. So if I am an assertive person, 75% assertive, 10% passive, 10% aggressive, 5% passive aggressive. But the cluster behavior person, combination of all four together. So the my point is very clear. The leader should have the assertive behavior. All right? Right. If you have any question, end of the thing, you can ask me, okay? All right. These are all the, some of the, what do you call it, does the characters. If you're a very passive leader, give up your own rights, not expressing your honest feeling, thoughts, and belief. Express yourself in a holistic way. Assertive leader, standing up for personal rights and expressing thoughts, feeling, and belief in direct, honest, helpful way, which do not violate the right of others. It's very important. One who do not violate the right of others is called the assertiveness. Respect your needs, thoughts. Opposite, aggressiveness. Stand up for personal right and express thoughts and feeling in a dishonest way by stepping on personal right of others. Poking nose with others, right? Dominate, force, win others to lose, right? This kind of qualities. These are all the basic assertive rights needed for a leader. I have the right to say, I do not know, I do not understand. Second one, I have the right to say no without feeling of guilty. If you don't want to say no, then you are a passive person. Don't say yes when you want to say no. That book is there. Please, whenever you get a free time, you can read a book. Don't say yes when you want to say no. I have the right to have express my own feelings to others. The fourth one, I have the right to determine my own boundaries and limitations. Fifth one, I have this right to set my priorities, personal life and also academic life priorities based on the needs. The sixth assertive rights of the leaders, I have right to make mistake, race, and be responsible. I should not repeat the mistake every time, right? The seventh basic assertive rights, I have the right to be treated with respect by others. The eighth one, I have the right to form my opinion, express this opinion. The ninth one, I have the right to have needs that are as important as other people's needs. Right? Suppose during the heavy rain, I shouldn't ask the other neighbor, why don't you give the umbrella? Because the umbrella needed for other person during the rainy season, right? If there is any extra, we can ask, right? That is why I have the right to have needs that are as important as other people's need. The 10th one, I have the right to have feelings and express these feelings which do not violate the dignity of others. The 11th one, I have the right to protect my body and mind against a drug or alcohol and say no. The last rights needed for the leader, I have the right to ask other people to respond my needs and decide whether I will take care of others' need. It is more of concern in nature. I think you can understand what is the basic assertive rights of the leaders. Participant, please react.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes, the next one, the sixth quality of the leader, attention. Participant, tell me about what is the difference between attention and concentration. Every time there is a disturbance in our class, please attention. Every time we are banging on the table, asking students to stand up. Very peculiar problem all over the world in a classroom. Getting attention, all right, a very big problem to the teacher. Yes or no? That is why we are having a program called classroom management. How to make a classroom pin drop silence through participative method. Student-oriented method, not teacher-oriented. Yes, participant, tell me about what is the difference between the attention and concentration?
Concentration means we are focusing on a specific thing.
Oh, attention.
And attention means we are means taking care of all the things, focusing on specific things which is happening.
Good, good, madam. Then what is the concentration?
Means that means you are focusing on a specific thing.
Yes, yes, yes. Of the word, whether the word we are using every day in a airport, attention please. Right, in a railway station, attention.
It is already this.
The passenger, all right, they always already talking with some other information, right, with the other friends or colleague, etc. But attention please means everyone is a focal point. So write down please, attention is a physiological process. Now you are attentive to my online program on the behavioral qualities of a leader. You are watching over through my PowerPoint. It is called attention. Attention is the physiological process. Being a leader, attention is more important. You should be attentive in nature. That means physical presence. It is a physiological response. It is related to SOR relationship. Write down SOR relationship. Stimulus organism response relationship. Put S hyphen O hyphen R. Stimulus. There are a number of stimulus available in a classroom. Stimulus means object. One is the teacher, S1. S2 blackboard. S3 PowerPoint. S4 model. Like there are so many stimulus are available in the classroom while you are teaching. Organism, nothing but the brain of what is student. So the interaction with this S1 to S4 to 60 brain. Right? Whether these stimulus enter into the 40 brain of the student, how will you know about response? Immediately asking question. Ramesh, you tell the answer. Vengadesh, you tell me the answer. That means if you complete SOR relationship, stimulus, organism, and response, this is what you call it as physiological process, then attention could be there. Now you are attending my class, no doubt. 128 students, maybe participants are attending my class. All right? Though I am not available, but my voice is available. My presentation is available. All right. Now, today you go home, take your dinner, right? Before go to your sleep, close your eyes, get the mental picture, mind picture. It's called mind mapping. From 10 o'clock to 11:30, what are the PowerPoint presented by the presenter, guest lecturer? Just close your eyes, get the picture about it. What are the 14 types he explained? What do you mean by IQ? All right, if you get the mental picture from 10 o'clock to 11:30, that is what you call it as concentration. Concentration, nothing but the psychological process. Attention is the physiological process. Without attention, concentration may not take place. But not all the attentive things need not to be concentrated. Suppose you are traveling from one place to another place by bus or car. You are seeing number of individuals. Right? But you are not getting the faces of each and every passenger, co-passenger, no. That is what you called selective perception. It is called attention. Right? Attention and concentration are work together. Attention is a physiological process. Concentration is a psychological process. One depend on another. It is called interdependent. So, as a leader, last two qualities are highly needed to our academic leader, attention and concentration. I think we have another 5 minutes. You have any kind of question, please ask me. Otherwise, I'll just go to the next one. Concentration. How? What are the method to analyze behavior? Just go through it. There are different methods. Is there called Sigmund Freud used a method is called introspection. Just tell about your past experience, how it has happened freely. The Sigmund Freud wanted to find out from the patient or the client, free to speak. Introspection. We have behavioral checklist, strength and weakness, SWOT analysis, strength, weakness, opportunity, and a threat. The one more R, it is called risk. Strength, weakness, opportunity, little bit of risk we have to take, then a threat. Another one is Zakaria window. Through the test, we can find out the leader qualities, objective method. Other objective methods are available. It is called questionnaire method, inventory method, rating scale, ranking scale, checklist, schedule or force choice test. Through that, we can find out the leadership qualities, whether the leader can be an autocratic leader or democratic or maybe a laissez-faire leadership or maybe people-oriented or task-oriented or both or balanced. Like that, different type of categorizations available, right? Then subjective method, one-to-one basis. If I want to find out the what kind of the leader, you know, it can be case study. The case study, nothing but the detailed study about a person and development of his problem, right? Example, all right? The Gandhiji is a good leader. So from the case study, you know, autobiography or biography, we are getting a lot of information. Case study, observation. Through the observation, we can understand the leadership qualities of other person. Or we can say the leader do not have such qualities. Anyway, unfortunately, he's the leader. Through the observation alone, we can understand, all right? One is the knowledge possessed by the leader, another is the skill possessed by the leader, and how the leader interacting with the other person. These are three phenomena will determine the excellent leader or the good leadership qualities. The third one is called field investigation. The last one is through experimental control study, we can find out what type of a leader. The last method we can call it as sentence complete projective method. When the first two methods are not in use or it may not give you very precise about what type of person, the third one we are using, it is called projective method. Projective method, nothing but the three types are available: sentence completion test, word association test, Rorschach-Miller test. So these tests are available to find out the how far a person having a quality, behavioral qualities of leader. With this, I close my topic. You have any question, please, I request the participant to ask me the question for another 2 minutes.
Thank you, sir. Dear participants, you can directly interact with sir regarding your questions. Dr. Usha Raju, madam, and Professor Mahalakshmi, madam.
Yes, sir. I'm here, sir.
Yeah, you can directly interact with sir.
Sir, good morning, sir. Good morning. Have a question, sir.
Yes, sure.
Can we judge a person by just his or her behavior alone, sir? Is it possible to identify a leader or any individual as such?
No. Moving with the number of days with the person, you can understand. Moving with the person, not the facial expression.
Yeah. Okay, sir. I understand.
Face is the index of mind. It can be.
Okay, sir.
Madam, through the facial expression, we cannot understand the leader. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Face is the index of mind. It can be overcome by fair and lovely. Like I used to call it. Right?
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Any other question, please?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Usha Raju.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I want to, can you explain passive aggressive behavior with examples?
Aggressive behavior, students always maybe an either verbal aggression, talking some kind of the bad languages, right? Or maybe, and because aggression, nothing but ventilated through the anger. Right. The anger. Anger, we call it as anger in, anger out, and anger control. Anger out is called aggression, right?
Yeah.
It can be a verbal aggression, shouting, murmuring, or sometimes instrumental aggression. Aggression means a beating and all, right? In a rowdyism, they never talk each other, go and beat another person or murder, you know. Aggression is a two-way, one is a verbal. The verbal is failure, the people go for the what do you call it? It's in a practice, instrumental. Instrumental means beating and all, because they want to show about they are the leader, in a gangster, you know, that leadership different. No, I am talking about, madam, only an academic leadership, okay? Aggression, how to minimize the aggression, how to minimize the anger. Anger is a destructive nature. How the anger can be make it a productive. So you can attend my program on anger management program in our life skill development in NITDR. You're welcome, madam. Or you can be very knowledgeable, then you can be a resource person also, Dr. Kshara Raju.
Sir, okay. How can a passive be an aggressive?
Pardon? Passive aggressive.
Yes, sir.
One time passive, another time is aggressive. When you ask some question and all inside the classroom, the person is calm and quiet. But go to the hostel, they'll make differently. That is called displaced aggression. At a place, he is calm and quiet without making any kind of disturbances. But in other side, he will. Suppose if you are asking one teacher the case study, when you ask a question, he never given any kind of answer. But evening, the same student punctured, teacher two-wheeler. Right? It is called passive aggressiveness. One time he's calm and quiet, build up his aggression. In otherwise, he done it some harsh to others. Right? That's called passive aggressiveness. One time passive, another time is very aggressive. Right.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
I take this.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Last question.
I am Dr. Mamta Takarkhede from JDCOEM.
Okay.
Sir, my question is, what efforts we have to take to improve the concentration?
There are a number of exercises, madam. I think you can go with self-hypnotism, yoga, pranayama mandal, right? Number of exercises available in order to improve your concentration, mental exercise. I think YouTube, you will get a lot of information, madam. Or you can send me an email. I'll give the list of the things you have to practice, right? In order to improve the concentration, right?
Thank you, sir.
I think I take this opportunity to thank Harisha because I had to go to a PhD Viva at 11:30. Okay, in my NITDR. I take this opportunity to thank the 143 participants, all right? Nicely they're interacting. Thank you very much, Harisha. Okay.
Dear sir, I am very much thankful to you for bearing the pain which I was started doing, I think, from last 6 months.
Yes.
Yeah.
You are a good leader.
Thank you so much, sir. And my intention is to deliver the best, and your guidance throughout conducting this particular FDP. I'm going to remember this forever. The moment I visited last year, I visited NIT Palghar for a training program.
Okay.
From that point of time, I started preparing for this FDP. Though I didn't get approval from AICT, I still wanted to continue the preparation process.
Sure,
I was so confident that I'll get approval this time. Anyway, this is the first time we received grant from AICT to conduct this particular FDP. And I'm so thankful to you, sir, because you have been guiding me for the last 1 year. And on behalf of my institution, Government Polytechnic Karnali, on behalf of my colleagues, principal, and on behalf of all the participants, I sincerely thank you, sir, for your valuable time and for this insightful session.
Thank you. Thank you, Ashok. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. Dear participants, I have an announcement for you. We'll be joining back at 12, Professor Anjula Gupu. She'll be from IISc Bangalore. We'll be delivering the next session. Take a short break, have a cup of tea, coffee, and will join us back at 12. Sure. Thank you.